is Isaac Sunleaf. My crew and I are making this documentary to show the school board the perspective of the students and teachers here at West High School, as a representation of many views throughout the community. Now, Tom Yates, the president of the Iowa City Education Association, stated that the school board wants to put the debate in financial terms, but teachers see it as one of educational quality. However, to those of us involved in education around the district, this is an argument about educational quality. Now, I could mention that from a business standpoint, education is the most stable and sound investment in the state of Iowa that the government funds. But that's beside the point. These are the stories of the people here at West, starting with mine. Now, when I was a freshman, I joined Showtime. And if I hadn't joined Showtime, I would not be where I am here today. After all, I have been in 8 musicals and plays, and I really am involved in all the theater and performance arts here at West High School. Now the thing is, if Showtime wasn't there, not only would I have not had my start, but I wouldn't have continued, because Showtime was what kept me in choir, which improved my dancing abilities, my singing abilities, and my overall performance abilities. And that would have led to me not having as many friends as I have now, and in general, just not being where I am here today. So that's my story. Let's hear some more.
Without the ability to hire potentially a new speech coach, the speech team is also really going to be in a world of hurt because we have a debate coach, and fortunately, Melanie, the debate coach, will be able to take us to tournaments. However, we won't have a designated speech coach to really kind of keep us all in check and to make sure that everybody's piece is coming along and coming along well and everybody's performance is top-notch, because as returning state champions, there's definitely a lot that is expected of the West High Forensics team.
I have been involved in the business department at West High for over 3 years, since I was a freshman, and the cuts are definitely going to impact the business department. The teacher cuts are going to reduce the number of teachers, which will affect the amount of students that can enroll in business courses. And less students mean less opportunities, and it would be very unfortunate to lose any of the wonderful opportunities that the business department offers.
So I was in the Princess Bride play at Theater West this year, and it really kind of opened up new opportunities and like new horizons for me to try. But since the theater classes are being cut this year, or for next year, it's reducing a lot of things that freshmen or anyone who wants to take a class is able to do. So like, if you want to like get ready for a play or to do something in front of people or to just kind of come out of your shell, it's reducing that. So it makes you feel like you can't do those things, or if you get into something, then you're just going to be shoved out of the way, and there's nothing to prepare you since the classes are taken away.
The effects that the art department will have is we'll lose 20% of our program, which means the elimination of individual programs within the department. So, for example, the Graphics Academy, which is digital imaging and Illustrator. We won't be able to offer some of our higher-end classes as well. So Advanced Art Studio more than likely would be eliminated, sculpture, and then video production. So anything that generally carries a smaller number will be eliminated.
Cutting teachers and cutting programs has a serious impact on kids' lives. The classes that get cut are electives. Those are the classes where kids really are able to find themselves, find what they like in life. A lot of them will make careers out of those electives. So, you know, I hope those who are in a position of power realize that the decisions they make will have tremendous, tremendous impact on the days and the lives of the kids of this district.
I feel like the budget cuts are going to negatively affect West High because our variety of courses offered is what makes us so culturally diverse and like allows us to open up and like experience the cultures and also the different areas of interest and explore different mediums and different things and learn so much more and adapt to life, and because a lot of the classes are things that you may use in life, like the home ec or the painting. I want to be an art major in college. For the next year, I signed up for 6 art courses as well as 2 trimesters of technical theater, and those programs are all on the line. I'm also a German student, and the German program is in jeopardy and that culture, and I went there on the foreign language trip, and that culture and the experience and everything that I've learned has just helped me grow as a person. And I feel like the cutting of these programs is going to negatively affect us and make us close our minds and not be able to get out and explore the wonderful options of this diverse schooling system.
Students agree with Natalie's opinion on cutting foreign languages, and others express concern for advanced physical education courses.
These budget cuts really affect me and my brother very personally because we both take German, and right now my brother's having a hard time. He's struggling in German. I keep telling him, chin up, because better everything starts clicking in level two, it'll be great. However, if you go through with these cuts and you cut German, he won't be able to get that experience, and he won't have the same teacher, which I've come to bond with, Frau Chuen. And it's just a completely different experience seeing your teacher on the line, being ready to cut.
I personally really don't like these cuts because my mother is actually a teacher at Northwest Junior High, and she teaches Spanish 1, so over the course of the next 3 years, she will be cut. So it really starts to make you think that, you know, it has a direct effect, stuff like this. Even though I'm a senior and I'm leaving, I still have a little sister who's in the school system. So it's really just, it's not a great thing, because eventually students get cheated out of foreign language and stuff that they used to have, and now they don't have it anymore. It's really unfair.
These cuts in our programs have really affected me, because if they go through with them, they'll cut advanced PE, which happens to be my favorite class. And through advanced PE, I've gotten really large strength gains that help me prepare for sports. And as the only girl on the West High football team, I need all the help I can get with strength.
I think with that program being cut entirely, I think our sports teams are going to suffer. I think the general fitness level of the student body will suffer. And I think also as a byproduct of the fitness level, I think that also might have an impact on the academic level of our class, because there have been many studies showing that an increased level of fitness also increases your performance on the academic side of things. So I think the budget cuts are going to really be a broad hindrance of everything. And I think one thing that really hits me personally is the advanced PE.
Teachers also have things to say about educational quality and class sizes.
Probably the biggest effect of the reduction in teachers at the secondary level will be an increase in class sizes. Right now, because we haven't actually hired a lot of teachers here at West, we already have class sizes that are in the low 30s, even sometimes at 35. It is predicted that with staff cuts, the average class size across the high school will be low 30s, 35, even upper 40s. One section in particular is anticipated to have 42 students in it, AP calculus, because as a result of the staff cuts, the two sections that would have been created are going to have to be combined. The teachers are saying that classes will have to start to be taught more like what you might get at the University of Iowa or another college, where you go into a large lecture hall setting. So there will be less individualized student attention from teachers as a result of the staff cuts.
To demonstrate the effect of the increased class sizes, we've added 12 students to one of this year's calculus classes to make it a class of 42, which is the estimated size of this class next year.
I can speak best to how it will affect my classes, and I know now that I'm going to have 28 students in each of my American Lit Honors classes, and I can handle that, and it's, you know, it'll be lively. But when I get to the third trimester, the students write 4 papers, and I can't even do the math. It takes me at least a half an hour to do each paper, so I think about the time commitment. That basically I did map it out so that even if I spent every single every single minute of my free periods for the entire trimester, I still wouldn't begin to get those papers graded. So that seems really confusing to me, plus the fact that kids don't get a chance to talk in class as much, and that makes me nervous.
You know, Iowa City has always prided itself on being committed to education, and if we want to have a world-class education, we need to fund it and have the resources necessary to do that. And I would argue, if that is the goal, who makes that happen? It's teachers. Teachers are the ones that make education world-class, and cutting teachers isn't the way to do that. Cutting teachers is antithetical to the mission of this district.
For the most part, I'm just really disappointed in the fact that the school district has decided to eliminate something that really makes this school district special. So when you're talking about music cuts, you're talking about art cuts, and all the specials areas, as well as then just the wide variety of things that are offered here that makes Iowa City different. It's the reason I came back to Iowa City. I graduated from here, and it's the reason that I'm committed to this community as well as to this school district.
Despite these issues, there is a possible solution.
School districts get their funding to fund schools and pay teachers from a variety of sources. Some of that money comes from the state, some of that money comes from community taxpayer dollars, usually in the form of property taxes. Most school districts have a certain percentage of money that they set aside in what is called a rainy day fund. The Iowa City Community School District's rainy day fund percentage is 5%. So in other words, of all the money that they bring in a year, they spend 95% of those funds. One of the proposals being batted around right now would be to change the percentage from 5% to 3%, and that extra money could then be used to save some of the teachers' jobs that are going to be affected as a part of the cuts. My understanding is that right now the 5% equals about $6 million in terms of the overall Iowa City schools budget.
If you, as an audience, learn anything from this video, it is that
it matters to me.
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 It matters to me, okay?
It matters.
It matters to me.
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 It so matters to me.
It matters to me.
It matters to me.
It matters to me.
It matters.